We just published a paper which shows that BRCA1 has a significant role in the development of the brain.
What we found out through this work is that BRCA1, a gene that's involved in breast and ovarian cancer, actually has implications for how brains become bigger or smaller through evolution.
It's well known that the loss of BRCA1 will lead to breast cancer. But we and others had not suspected that BRCA1 also have a significant role in the development of the brain. What is remarkable is a study that we were trying to figure out the role of BRCA1 in cancer has actually led us to some very interesting new principles. And that, of course, is always very exciting in science when you start with one thing, but you learn something you didn't know before.
This work has important implications to understand how the brain is built, breast and ovarian cancer, how that is formed, and how DNA damage is sensed by cells.
DNA is a double-stranded molecule, but sometimes during division and other sudden events that might happen, there's breaks in the DNA. BRCA1 helps package DNA properly. It confers stability to the DNA, so the DNA will not break so easily. The overall message we should get is that all the cells have BRCA1, but abnormal copies of the gene is what ultimately will lead to cancer.
One of the interesting things about this study at the Salk Institute is that it could not have been done at any other place.
At the Salk Institute, we have this unique structure, like labs without physical separations, that we actually collaborated with a lab next door to work on the neural stem cell aspect. And then when we actually had results on neurodevelopment, we worked with Dennis O'Leary, which is on the other side of the building. It actually took 10 years to complete this work because numerous genetic manipulations and also to analyze all the data, it took an entire 10 years.